What's up, y'all? This is Shadow Rockin' ProfoWon of the Floor Gangs and the Knuckle Neck Tribe. And what we're gonna do today in this tutorial is we're gonna learn about musicality. Now, musicality isn't just about hitting every note or hitting every beat. It's about dancing to the music. So what we're gonna do today is listen, feel, and flow. So what we're doing today is trying to get the atmosphere of the song. And what I mean by the atmosphere is that we're getting the feeling. Because most b-boys at jams, all they do is this. Like, it'll be like a Michael Jackson song, that's what they're doing. It'll be a hip hop song and it'll be still like at the same tempo or at the same rhythm. So what we're gonna do today is we're gonna take three different songs and understand each and every song, the style, the time period, even the type of style of dance they did to that. The first song I picked was Mongo Santa Maria's Cloud Nine, an Afro-Cuban funk song. Very common in a lot of b-boy jams, you'll hear this. High energy, fast rhythm, fast tempo, a lot of congas and drums, which makes a quintessential b-boy break. Type of music has a consistent drum pattern, a consistent flow. So if you noticed, a lot of the early b-boys, it wasn't really about hitting crescendos and anything like that. It was just following the drum pattern and the rhythm. So you're hitting the twos, the fours, the sixes, the eights, and just movement to movement, not really anticipation of when is the next cymbal crash coming. And this is what a lot of the early breaking was. It was just about building movements on top of a consistent rhythm. The second song I picked is James Brown's Cold Sweat. This is, to me, is where soul transitioned into funk. Clyde Stubblefield played the drums for him at the time, and he just made this funky, funky pattern, and this is what the song is built around. So we're gonna do two dances from the time, which is the mashed potato and the boogaloo, and what I'm gonna do after that is how to add it to your breaking. So the first dance I'm gonna show you is what they call the boogaloo. All neck and hips.
Your pants.
Right? Second dance is called the mashed potato. James Brown made it really popular, which is
I love to laugh. I don't care, darling.
So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna take those two feelings, those two dances, and combine it and put in your breaking. What I just demonstrated was more of an anticipation of the rhythms. It was more of a swing. And it wasn't just like the Mongo Santa Maria song, where it was just pattern, 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 following that type of tempo. It was more of this anticipation and crescendos and staccato. And plus with that little understanding of how they did their dances with the boogaloo and the mashed potato, you can see how it emulated, it grabbed the meat of the song and just went in there, and that to me is what musicality is. As you can see, I'm still using b-boy foundation, but I took the essence of the two dances and added it to it. That's how you come up with different flavors. So now what we're gonna demonstrate is early 90s hip hop, and the song I picked is International Zone Coaster by Leaders New School. The two dances I'm gonna demonstrate is the Broken Down Running Man and the Pump It Up. All right, the first dance I'm gonna show you is called the Pumping Up. You can see a lot of the MCs in the early 90s doing this while they're rapping. There's a New School, Tribe Called Quest, this was a dance. All right, second dance is the Broken Down Running Man. It is the Running Man, but broken down. So instead of here, it's okay. Broken Down Running Man. So now we're gonna add it to your B-Boy foundation.
Around the room, fellas feeling good
All right, as you saw, we did three different songs. And even though it's three different songs, we used the B-Boy Foundation, but we used it in three different ways. So the first way was to Mongo Santa Maria's Cloud 9, which was more like what we normally see, how we go from pattern to pattern. We go from movement to movement. It was a driving force, a driving beat that just kept going. The second was a soul funk song, which is James Brown's Cold Sweat. And we used those movements like the boogaloo and the mashed potato, where it was more staccato, more using the crescendos, more anticipating the music. And then our last was an early hip hop song called International Zone Coaster by Leaders New School. We used the dances such as the Pump It Up and the Broken Down Running Man, and we used that atmosphere, that feeling to break down into our breaking. So what I hope is that you guys, next time you hear a song, you really try to understand it. You don't have to know where it's from. You just have to listen and get that feeling. What were they doing at the time? What were the dances at the time? And try to feel that, and then let whatever dance style you do, whether it's whacking, house dancing, locking, popping, or breaking, you just bring that feeling, that essence of the song into your dance. Hope I've been helpful. This is ProfoWon, and I'm out.